Good morning, everyone. We want to welcome you to our science demonstration entitled A Bouquet of Flowers. Now, I brought some pretty roses here today that someone allowed me to do who had a birthday this week. And these are her roses. I also have some white roses, or not roses, white carnations and daisies that I've brought with me. Now, to do this demonstration, you just need something white. And you need food coloring. Now, carnations work best. Queen Anne's lace also works well, but of course it's a little early to pick that from our fields today. But so we're using carnations, and we're also using white daisies. Now, and the reason I chose this little demonstration, it's a common demonstration. You've probably have seen it done before, especially if there are children in your home, because they do this a lot for science fairs. And we'll just leave this one alone.
Yeah, just
okay. Now, and what we have here are some carnations and daisies and water. And over here we have the same carnations and daisies in colored water, and we have a junior scientist at home who has depleted my supply of food colorings. And so you may not be able to see the change in color in these white flowers as readily as if you had had, if I had had plenty of drops of red food coloring and blue food coloring and whatever. So if you're doing this at home, make sure you put lots, many, many, many drops in, and especially if you're using more water, and you have to slice the ends off of your of the stems to get fresh ends to it. Now let's look at slide number 2. It's a person, a picture of a person in Spain who received this beautiful bouquet of flowers because it was her birthday too. Slide 3 is another picture of some beautiful flowers. Slide 4 is a rose that happened, one rose that happened to have 3 buds on it. I don't know how they managed to do that, but there it is. And all you need in slide 5, it tells you some vases, or you could use plastic water bottles and just kind of maybe half fill them, put lots of food coloring in them, and put the stem of one particular flower. You could do one, yeah, you have to cut it first, and you have to, and you could use one bottle for blue, one for green, one for yellow, one for red. And here's a picture of someone who's done that. Yes, Ashley?
Also, a neat thing to do is take one flower and cut the stem into 4 parts and put it in 4 different colors.
Yes.
And you can have 4 different.
Right, and I tried to do that. Slide 7 shows these particular, they look like test tubes, but they're a little bigger than that, with the different coloring. Maybe after 12 hours, the flowers are starting to change. And then after 24, 36 hours, the color gets deeper. That was slide 8. Slide 9 shows it just beginning. Isn't that pretty, the way the blue is just starting to work its way up the stem? And slide 10 are some carnations that have been in the food coloring containers there at the bottom, you can see on slide 10. Now, the reason this works is, and this is slide 11, the leaves and petals of some plants contain many small pores. And water evaporates through these pores, and as it does, the plant brings up more water through its stem to replace the water that's evaporated. And if we put colored water and the stem in colored water, it's going to suck up that colored water and change the color of the petals. Blue or red dye is very good for outlining how this works in the plant as it draws water and dye up the stem. And you can see it. If we should cut open or cut this apart, you could see the different sections that suck up the water.
The xylem.
The xylem. You're right, Ashley. That's right. It is called xylem. Now, in our demonstration, the thing I wanted to do the most was to cut a stem in half, like I've done here, and put one half in one color of water, let's say blue, which my junior scientist depleted, and let's say the other half in red. which also was missing. Nevertheless, you could do that if you had two containers that I could fill up to this point, so it could suck up red on this side and blue on this side, but I didn't. I couldn't use that much water. So unfortunately, our demonstration today will not show one plant with two different colors on it, but it works and you could try it. You have to just split the stem and put one stem in one color of water and the other stem in the other, and just wait, and it will work.
We could put that in clear and red.
We could do that. This junior scientist of mine already has ideas of how to.
Okay.
Anyway, the reason I'm telling you this is we're in slide 13. And now, the reason I'm doing this, the Israelites were gathered around Mount Sinai. Moses had told them to prepare. God was coming to meet them. And the Lord did come, and he spoke to them. And the hearts of the Israelites were full of appreciation and fear of him, and they wanted to solely be his. Just like in this particular container inside, I have yellow. That was the coloring I had most of. And the petals are starting to turn yellow. Just like the Israelites, they wanted to be filled with his spirit. And these white daisies and carnations are going to be full of yellow pretty soon, just like the Israelites wanted to be full of his spirit. Unfortunately, later, Moses climbed the mountain and spent a long time with God, receiving instruction from him, and the Israelites were down waiting for him to return, and they didn't. He didn't return, and they grew tired of waiting and even decided, well, it'd be better to serve the gods we used to serve instead of this God who spoke to us from Mount Sinai. And so they still had some leanings toward the Heavenly Father, just like this plant. Part of them wanted to serve God, but the other part of them wanted to serve the idols that they were used to from Egypt. And they talked Aaron into forming a golden calf for them. And, you know, we can't serve God and Satan at the same time. Here, let me move this down here. On slide 14, when Moses did not return from Mount Sinai in an appropriate time, as they thought, the Israelites grew distrustful of God. They wanted to worship an idol instead of God, so they made a golden calf. Now their hearts were divided between God and Satan, represented by a flower with two colors.
This one's starting to turn red.
And this one is starting to get some of the red up. You're right, Ashley.
I wanted to ask a question. If we took a rose and dipped it into blue food coloring, do you think by any chance it might like start having a little blue in it?
It would draw it up. Now there, I should tell our listeners, there's one thing that will stop the water from going up the stem, and that's if an air bubble gets in that particular tube of xylem and the water can't go up. So if it doesn't work for you or only half works for you, that could be the reason that air bubbles are blocking the tube of xylem. And you could get a white rose especially and do this with.
But with the red rose.
With the red rose, it would draw up the color, yes.
But would you be able to see it?
Since it's already red, and if you're drawing up blue,
would it start to turn black?
It might turn black, that's right. But you would see a difference. Now, these roses are more open, and I'm not sure how much more water they will draw up. But especially if you have fresh roses, they will change colors. That's right.
I want to try that.
We can try that, Miss Scientist, later on, after Sabbath school. Now we want to go to slide 15. God wants you to be all you can be. And you don't have to be like anyone else. You might be a rose, a daisy, symbolically speaking. You don't have to be like anyone else. All God wants is your heart. And you can't serve him and Satan too. You must choose to whom you will surrender. Paul said he died daily, and so must we. Our eyes must be single to the glory of God. Then we will be beautiful flowers, and His church will be a beautiful garden of all kinds of colors and flowers, symbolically speaking. But when we give our hearts to our Father and Savior, then we are His, and they will fill us with their Spirit, and we will be solely His, and then we will be beautiful, just like slide 16 shows us. A beautiful garden of all kinds of colorful flowers. And this is the kind of garden that Ashley has planned for outside her window, she tells us. And we have big plans. All right.
Small areas.
Now, before we end our science demonstration, there's another little treat we can do for the birds. And this is fun to do, especially if you have young children in the home. All you need is an old toilet paper roll. With the toilet paper gone, just save a couple of those. You punch two holes in the side and tie some twine to it. But what's the best part is that you take some peanut butter, because birds love peanut butter. Some birds do, I should say. And you just kind of coat that. And yes, Ashley, you do this for me. You coat, and it doesn't have to be perfectly coated. Just spread some around. You can put your fingers in and hold it. Whoops, like that. Because this peanut butter is going to be the glue that will hold some seeds on it. And while you're doing that, I'm wondering how our orange seed feeder that we put outside the office window has been doing. We'll have to check
that. I can bring it in.
No, we'll just, you might be able to, but let's just get this finished. So what you need is a toilet paper roll, some peanut butter, and some bird seed, and twine. And we'll just use that much, Ashley. We won't finish it right now because we do need to move on.
I'll run outside and get the orange.
Well, let's finish this. Get it done right so we can roll it in the seed and then hang it up for our birds. Because things haven't started to grow. This is the hard time. Early spring is the hard time for birds because things aren't growing and there aren't many seeds for them. You see how that's sticking? Birds and squirrels will probably love this. So we roll it around in the seeds, and it's fun for little fingers to do. Samantha would enjoy this. If Samantha were here, maybe we can do this sometime for Samantha. And there you have a bird feeder that you can hang up outside in a bush, on a limb of some sort, from a plant feeder. And it's simple to do, and the birds will like it. So until we meet again, may God bless you, and I hope to see you next Sabbath morning. Bye-bye.